Yo, what's up? This is an Urban Hype exclusive. It's your boy Tucker HD. The Innocence is, what can I say? It's basically about a broken relationship. And it was actually supposed to be part of July, the project I dropped last year, 2016, on my birthday. It just so happened that Innocence, as well as a couple of other songs, were not ready. So I figured that with time, I would complete them and let them out to the fans, to the people, while I kept working on something else. So that's basically what Innocence is. Life experience. Most of my songs are real life, though. I don't think I've ever written a song about something that totally has nothing to do with me. But the thing is, with Innocence, it's one of those songs whereby you have to be in the moment to execute it right. Otherwise, it would just sound like any other song. But yeah, it is real. You had to go in your feelings and write something that actually held some. Yeah. Well, there's a project in the works. It's not definitive yet. I'm not sure whether it's an EP or a mixtape or an album. I thought that's not important to decide at the moment. At the moment, I'm just putting in more work than I put in last year. So I'm just trying my best to record as much music as possible. And obviously, there'll be more material coming out because, I think everyone would agree, I wasn't so active last year. And I wanted to change the narrative this year. So Innocence was the first to get out of the way because it was more ready than everything else. But that's the start, so there'll be much more music coming. I think the thing with music is, it's a feeling. Like, if you wake up tomorrow feeling like the best, or feeling like, I need to do this, and you don't do it, 9 times out of 10, when you wake up tomorrow, the idea will be gone, you'll be feeling like something else. So Bars and Rolex Stands was a concept I developed. It must have been like 2011, 2012. And I had so many ideas. But for those who know me and were following my steps by then, that's around the time Airport Taxi kind of became what it became, what people got to know as Airport Taxi. So what I had initially crafted as my solo work had to take a step aside so that we could focus on Airport Taxi. And by the time I got more time to work on my stuff, I had elevated from that mindset. Oh, you might get it. Because like, that's the interesting thing. What I meant was, when I came up with the concept and the name, it's different in my head right now. I know the name stuck because it was catchy and everything. What I had created for Bars and Rolex Stands then, I will probably never get to hear because I feel like I've grown as an artist. I'm not going to give you that work. So I can't confirm or deny, but what I was going to give the fans as Bars and Rolex Stands then, no, you're not going to get it. You're going to get much better stuff. When Libok left, I won't say we got stuck, because the reality is we had created so much music. We had created so much music together, so much good music together. We had shot a couple of videos, one or two that the public did get to see. But the trick is, with a group, when one of the members leaves, it kind of disorganizes the whole plan, because as you see, we could no longer release that music as Airport Taxi because he was no longer part of us. We had so many things planned, but when one person left, there was a void, not even with the music, but just with the brand itself, Airport Taxi. So what we decided to do was take a break and develop more on our own for, say, a year or two, and then come back together and decide, me and Martha, if we still wanted to pursue Airport Taxi as a group, as a duo, or not. So we are still in that phase. We feel like it was important, because you see, the thing with groups is, I can wake up tomorrow and say, no, I want to leave, you know, but then as people who have developed together, we wanted to have that, like, okay, if Tucker wakes up and leaves tomorrow, Martha's good because she has also grown as an artist. She has grown as an artist and grown as Airport Taxi. So that's what we're working on, is personal growth. Mainly this year, you're going to hear a lot from the both of us. For the fans, I'm still in touch with Martha Smalls on very, very good terms. That's like a sister to me. So there's always possibility of Airport Taxi music coming. Or are people ready to receive the music? Because there's a lot of music. There's something else coming in a week's time, I think. In a week's time, a week or two, I have more and more exclusives for Urban Hype. It's going to be like, there should be a few months of exclusives before we get to the big songs I've been working on that I want you guys to hear. So there's definitely going to be much more music. Yeah. Well, to me, I think Ugandan hip-hop is, it's in that state where it's still realizing itself up to now. It's still realizing itself because we pick examples from, let's say, around the continent, and we see the different paths hip-hop is taking around the continent. And it's huge. Like, we see the moves people in SA are making, we see the moves in Nigeria. You see the moves people are making, and we're still in this phase of, oh, okay, we can still get here. But I think what's missing is the work. The work is not there. The work is not there. I've had this conversation with several people who can say this, that, and the third is what's wrong with the Ugandan hip-hop industry. Which is fine. It's perfectly fine. I probably also have some grievances. But I believe right now what counts at this stage is working to fix that. If you identify a problem, if you say, I'm not happy with this, what matters is, what are you doing to fix it? If you're not fixing it, then you actually won't know if you have a solution or not. So I think we are not just working hard enough.